सो लेट्स डिस्कस वन क्वेश्चन इन एथिक्स. लेट्स ए 51-year वर्ल्ड पर्सन विथ कोकीन एब्यूज, आई मीन टू से डेट एनी आई वी ड्रग एब्यूज, इज शेड्यूल टू अंडर गो कोलोनोस्कोपी. ओके, एंड व्हाइल प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द प्रोसीजर ए स्टाफ नर्स एक्सीडेंटली सफर्स अ needle stick injury while placing IV line on the patient. Okay, so patient in physician in charge of the case notifies the appropriate administration and orders immediate lab testing for infectious disease like HIV, hepatitis B, hepatitis C. Okay, and when informed, the patient becomes very upset and refuses to give blood for test as he does not want to be tested for HIV. So patient tells that I do not want to be tested for HIV. He insists that he is at very low risk and testing would be unnecessary. So what will we do next? So I am giving you option. One option is offer patient option of being tested for HIV without being informed of result. Okay, and another option is do not test patient, initiate nurse on antiretroviral. I mean to say that HIV prophylaxis medication. And another option is do not test patient and arrange close follow-up and testing for the nurse. So what will you do now? Or another option is interview patient if he has any risk factors for HIV. So what do you think is most appropriate? I think do not test patient and initiate use of HIV prophylaxis. If you think that this should be offered patient of being tested for HIV without being informed of result, it creates further ethical dilemma. Why? Because let's say patient is tested and it came out positive, HIV positive, and if you don't inform this patient of his result, then what will happen? This patient will continue to transmit this disease unknowingly to others. Okay, so this creates more ethical dilemma. That's why I think it's better offer the patient. I mean to say that do not test the patient and initiate patient on antiretroviral. I mean to say that HIV prophylaxis medications. And HIV prophylaxis medication should be started as soon as possible because the efficacy decreases as time passes. Okay. So it significantly decreases the rate of transmission following exposure and should be implemented immediately following suspected exposure as efficacy decreases over the course of hours. And HIV prophylaxis can be discontinued following receipt of negative test result from the source patient, but it must be continued if the patient continues to decline testing. Okay.